Hello everyone. Today I am Rishabh Bhardwaj, starting a new lecture series of automobile engineering. Let's start with the introduction of automobile. What is automobile? Automobile is a derived from two words, that is auto and mobile means movable. Self-movable vehicle, that is automobile vehicle. Now, firstly, we have to study about what is vehicle. Vehicle is a device or a machine which allow us to move the passenger as well as some goods. And self-generated energy vehicle, that is automobile vehicle, is generally used for transporting goods as well as passengers. There are different types of automobile vehicles, that is two-wheeler, four-wheeler, six-wheeler, eight-wheelers, and many more. Let's start with their classification of automobile. The automobile is classified based on their purposes. First, we have passenger vehicles. Passenger vehicles that, for example, bus, car, train, these are our passenger vehicles which can transport passengers in it. Then secondly, we have good vehicles. Good vehicles mean it carries some goods, luggages, couriers. They are, for example, they are good carriers, trolleys, lorry, trains, and etc. If we talk about the based on load capacity, we have light duty vehicle and simultaneously we have heavy duty vehicle. Light duty vehicle are car, van, jeep, motorcycle, in which lightweight goods or passenger can be transported. In heavy duty transportation vehicle, we have bulky motor vehicles, that is truck, bus, train, etc. Now the next classification is based upon the fuel used. First is petrol engine, second diesel engine, third gas vehicle, and third electric vehicle, and fourth is steam engine. Initially we start with petrol engine, that is car, scooter, motorcycle, that runs on the fuel, that is petrol. They are very lightweight vehicles, generally used for the economy as well as in daily life. Everyone uses the cars, scooters, and motorcycles. Then we have a diesel engine vehicle. Diesel engine vehicle are the most powerful engines. They are generally used in trucks, buses, tractors, where heavy loads we have to use. Then in gas vehicles, we have gas vehicles like turbine. And even nowadays, even cars also have installed CNGs, LPGs, on biofuels, etc. Electric vehicles are the vehicles in which is run on the electricity, like electric trains, electric cars, electric buses, and many more. Next is steam engine vehicle. Steam engine vehicle is vehicle that runs on a steam engine. Steam engine generally works on the steam power. That steam power will rotate the turbine, and the further mechanical work will convert it into electricity or used as a motion to just move forward. Next classification is based upon the vehicle. We have left hand drive, right hand drive, and fluid drive. In India, we have right hand drive vehicle in which the steering wheel is on the right side. If we're talking about the US, in US we have left hand drive, the steering wheel is on left side. And third one is fluid drive. Fluid drive is like a torque converter, fluid flywheels, hydrodynamic or hydromatic transmissions. In there the vehicles can be classified. The next one, the classification is based upon the wheels and the axis. We have two-wheeler vehicles like motorcycle, scooter, and etc. And the three-wheelers like tempo, auto rickshaw, and luggage carrying vehicles. Four-wheeler vehicles, that is car, van, jeep, truck. These are the four-wheeler vehicles. Then six-wheelers. Six-wheeler are like buses, trucks, and etc. Number of wheels and axles are depending upon the load. If we have to use low load, then we will use motorcycles, scooters, or we can say the two wheelers or three wheelers. If we talking about the passenger goods or the luggage goods, we need to use four wheelers and six wheelers and many more. Even it could be a 10 tires or 40 tires trucks and etc. Based upon the type of transmission. Transmission generally known as the gearbox. Initially, we can recognize or we can bifurcate by automatic transmission, manual transmission, and semi-automatic transmission. Generally, in economic wise and in daily life, we can see we use automobile as manual operated, which are more economic in nature right now, we can say. And automatic. Nowadays, the trend is about for automatic, in which different vehicles comes with automatic transmission, and it means we don't have to change gears. That is auto gear shift. We don't have to change the gear by, and we are in jam, we have to change the gear, we have to come in lower gear, and again we have in either in when I am if we are in highway, we have to change again gears. There is no complication over this. That is automatic gears. That is quite easy for us to drive in a crowded city and etc. Third one is semi-automatic transmission. Semi-automatic transmission means we don't have to change the gear by pedal of clutch. Automatically, the clutch will be get pressed and the gear will be changed. The new technology that is auto gear shift, that is semi-automatic transmission. Next classification is based upon the suspension used. Suspension, there are two types of suspension. Generally, we are talking about conventional and independent. Conventional, so conventional suspension was type leaf spring. If you have seen in the trucks and tractors, tractor trolleys, they use leaf springs for their suspension. Generally, in the four vehicles and two wheelers and many more, we use independent suspension, that is coil spring, pneumatic suspension, torsion bar, and etc. Mainly, the pneumatic suspension is the top and the latest technology we are using in our automobile. We have component of automobile. If we see, we have different components of the automobile, like rear view mirror, wind frame, sheet, windshield wiper, steering wheel, windshield washer, air filter, battery, distributor, radiator, alternator, oil filter, disc brake, body side mounting, line shaft, muffler, transmission, wheels, spare wheels, tail light, trunks. We have about 84,000 components in our automobile, which we can say which are useful and very helpful for making our vehicle move. Now we have automobile body. Basically, the automobile body is a component. Initially, we have a frame that is known as chassis. This is the chassis, which is the bottom layer of the car. Body, and this is our body on that is mounted over the chassis. Chassis and the body are the two different parts, and they are assembled or mounted over there, so that we can make a single component. What is the uses and the function of chassis? To support the vehicle mechanical component and the body, we need a chassis. Chassis is the basically base of the car. The chassis is also deal with static and the dynamic loads under undue reflections and distortions. Now we're talking about the car body. Car body have several parts, that is pillar, roof panel, quarter roof panel, shutters, front bar, tunnel, center pillar, and etc. The main function of the body is vehicle body is the main supporting structure of the vehicle to which all the components are attached. Doors, back doors, bonnets, hood, and roof lining, all the components are assembled over or mounted over our body, not on the chassis. Engine and see engine seats, and the last one is gutter. They have the mountings over there, so they can mount over engine, car seats, and boot space. Let's move with the next one, that is car body design. If we're talking about the car body design, now initially we have unitized body. What does it mean, unitized? You know that unitized is unitized, bifurcate. If you bifurcate this word, unitized, unit means one. If we make complete chassis and body as a one component, what are their benefits and what will be the loopholes? We are just discussing about that. Unitized body is the most commonly used frame body in modern cars. Initially, we have in 21st century, and we are getting a modern cars in which the chassis and the bodies are one component. It is self-supporting body built up as a single unit. They are made up of as a single unit. It builds the hollow steel parts onto which the other body panels, such as cross members, roof frame, side members, etc., are welded over the ropes. And unitized body is not generally preferred for the trucks, as the truck size is very large and long. We have such limitations to build a unitized body in trucks. Unibody construction also introduced in lighter vehicles, therefore resulting in higher mileage. Higher mileage goes to higher economy. It is easier to manufacture unitized body and improves the interior space for the passenger. It does not have any frame instead of tubular four. What is the utility of the unitized body? Strength. If we're talking about the strength and the rigidity, the steel metal provides the strength, and the uses of hollow pillars provide the torsional and the bending rigidity to the structure. The rigidity should be high enough to understand the elastic deformations. If we talk about the integrity, continuous vibration can stress on body, and which lead to the cracks and the welding failure. But the engine support cross member is highly suspicious to such failure due to the vibration of engine and the transmission. If you're talking about the repairing, the body parts which deform after the accident must be easily replaceable. There must be a suitable access of the exterior parts from the inside and outside of panels, etc. And to be bolted and welded, repair work is difficult in unitized body structure, as we can't change or replace complete body part. Then we have a car body style. Different body styles we have. First, initially, we have a hatchback. Hatchback is mainly a small car. For example, we have Baleno, Swift. These are the hatchback in which we have don't have long boot. Secondly, pickup truck. Pickup truck are the cars which are multi-utility vehicle, in which passenger as well as good passenger goods as well as goods are can be traveled or transported. Third one we have hatchback three door. Hatchback three door means initially we have studied about the hatchback five doors, which conclude two front doors, two back doors, and a rear boot door. Now we have hatchback three door. Hatchback three door means we have three access doors, that is two front doors and one rear boot door. We don't have rear doors in that. Then we have SUV, that is super utility vehicle. Super utility vehicles are the off-road vehicles. Generally, it is the most powerful vehicle that can be run over mountains, desert, in water, and etc. They are multi-utility. They have super utility vehicles. Then we have sedan. Sedan basically a premium car in which we have a four doors, which have a boot space, long boot space. We even have a hood, and even we have a hood also. Then we have a bus body. Bus bodies. We have initially, if you have seen that the automobile industry manufacture only chassis, they only provide you the chassis. You have to make their own body, own sitting capacity or seats additional by their manufacturers. The bus and the truck board chassis are has been issued or sold by the showrooms and other bodies. You can see here, this is the chassis of the truck or bus, in which we have to make outer body by sheet metals and other parts. Depending upon the sitting capacity or the loading capacity, we have to arrange all the seats and the passenger goods, luggage carriers, trolleys, spacing and boot space according to our need. This is all enough, and thank you for watching this video, and we will back to soon with the lecture 2.